Hi, I'm Andy Banbursky, and I'm a postdoc at the Center for Brains, Minds, and Machines and the Poggio Lab at MIT. My work in recent years has focused on understanding how it is exactly that deep networks work so well, and we have finally gotten to some kind of understanding. There are several pieces to this puzzle. The first of these is in the approximation power of deep networks. Why is it that deep networks work so much better than shallow networks if we've known for quite some time that they are both universal approximators? What this means is that they are both equally capable of approximating any function, however, at exponential cost. We have managed to show, however, that when you consider functions that are functions of functions of functions of functions of a few constituent variables, that is, they are hierarchically local, then suddenly if we use convolutional deep neural networks, which also have this kind of hierarchical locality, suddenly this exponential cost goes away and things become linear again. What this means is that for problems that have this property, which include image classification, deep networks are exponentially more powerful than shallow networks. A more surprising part of the puzzle has been the fact that deep networks perform very well out of sample. Traditional statistical knowledge suggests that if you want to fit your model to data, you should have less parameters than data. Unfortunately, or fortunately, deep networks are exactly the opposite. They are massively overparameterized. So how is it that these models that are not explicitly regularized in any way perform well on data they've never seen before? We have managed to show that if you just take your standard deep network and you train it with gradient descent algorithms, everything that everyone has been using for the last few years, turns out that for classification problems, gradient descent doesn't really care about the norm or the size of the weights, but really just about the direction in parameter space. What this means is now that the dynamics of gradient descent on deep networks are equivalent to those of having imposed an explicit constraint on the norm, on the size of your parameters. This leads to gradient descent converging to something known as the max margin solution. Taken together with some of our other recent work, showing that maximization of margin leads to maximization of stability, which in turn leads to provably convergence to solutions that minimize empirical risk, that is, they are going to be performing as best as they can out of sample, we finally have an understanding. This is an extension in a way of results that have been known in linear models for some time, in which support vector machines converge to something known as the pseudo-inverse solution, which doesn't really care about the number of parameters. Instead, it cares about minimizing the norm of solutions, which is equivalent to this margin maximization. Taken together, these results finally give us an understanding of why deep networks work so well and why they've been so widely successful. More importantly, however, this theoretical understanding should allow us to develop new algorithms that will learn faster and better.